many of you in here today have been bullied?
Bullying is a very serious issue, whether it's physical, whether it's verbal, or whether it's cyber.
So, now what?
Well, I say we water it and watch it rise from the ashes, just like me. I think there'll be a payoff to this.
This would have worked a lot better when we had $20.
Whoa,
oh,
bro!
Our money tree!
Stepped on our money tree!
What are you doing?
Hey, we're friends, right?
Depends.
We don't have any friends.
How many jackets you got?
Aren't you sweating?
No. Are you sweating?
No, it's the opposite. I'm freezing.
Yeah. You got an extra small in there?
Yeah, just for you, man.
Is that a Carhartt?
What's it gonna take for us to get one of these jackets?
Can you kick a kid's ass for me?
How old is he?
Like, 12?
Old enough for an ass.
Yeah, old enough. Give me no jacket.
All right.
Oh, hurt. Yeah, man.
Get the hood off me. Ah! Okay.
Why is this coat smell like weed?
Look, Ethan, I don't know what kind of nefarious plan you have.
Nefarious?
Well, we're not falling for this. Look, when you stole our jobs at that referee event.
Yeah, just like when you stole our likeness at that backyard wrestling event.
Or you took our only $20 doing that magic trick.
That's $20 we could use for our money tree.
Look, I don't care what kind of problem you have. You're on your own.
Yeah. Look who's sweating now. F*** off, kid.
I know who's sweating. It's us. Sweet!
That was pretty damaging.
I think you damaged his feelings.
Yeah.
I think he broke his feelings.
Those feelings are broke.
Bye.
You gonna cry now?
He's crying.
It's all right, Ethan. You got this. Just stand up to the bully. You got this. Yeah.
Wait.
Are you being bullied, Ethan?
Yeah, it's pretty ironic, huh?
Is that Alanis Morissette?
It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife.
It's like meeting the man of your dreams.
And then meeting his beautiful wife.
Isn't it ironic? Don't you think?
A little too ironic. But I really do think.
No one cares about the 1990s.
It's like rain!
We're here for a simple reason. Just to tell you. Just as hurtful.
Is he wearing an Alice in Chains t-shirt?
Yeah, I probably got it from his dad. Two! Sweet!
That was a terrible joke. Can you just talk to him?
Do you want us to break his legs?
No, it's way too far.
Just one leg then.
No! Just go talk to him.
Well, if we break one of his legs.
Then we'll break his teen spirit. Look, Ethan, we're kind of like a monkey's paw, so you either deal with us
or you deal with him.
I should have thought this through.
You sure should have. Let us know when we get back!
Hey. Nice Alice in Chains t-shirt.
Yeah. Get it from your dad. Two.
Sweet.
Good one.
Really?
It is?
Ethan doesn't understand our humor.
Ethan? Are you guys like his dads?
That's a good one.
Seeing what you did there. You ready for this ass beating or what?
Hurry up and break his leg already.
Look, based on the way you guys smell, I'm gonna guess you mean business.
Well, the good news is we've decided to only break one of your legs.
The gooder news is we're gonna let you pick which one.
Bet that cast's gonna smell like teen spirit.
I love Nirvana.
Wait, how do you...
What's your favorite band?
Well, I like Soundgarden and Pearl Jam, too.
Bro, best of all time.
What the f*** is happening?
Man,
you seem pretty cool.
Thanks. You two seem pretty cool, too. Oh my god, what the f is happening? Oh, son of a
bitch. Oh man, this kid's pretty cool, right?
He likes Soundgarden. He said we can come over and play.
He was my friend first.
You want to break his leg.
You wanted to break his non-dominant. Like, what son of
behind you.
By the way, you're welcome to Pilver too if you want.
I was bullied my entire life. I was always made fun of because it was small, short, and fat.
My mom's out of town, you guys. Why don't you get us some snacks so we can watch a DVD?
You think he has DVD on VHS?
Dude, stop f***ing this up for us.
Those chips over there. I don't care about the chips.
Pop beer.
Dude, we said pop.
Lucky I didn't spill my coffee.
You're lucky that there's Lucky Charms, bro.
There's
food in here.
I'd have dropped you so fast.
You're gonna drop me? Bro, you're lucky we decided not to drop our new best friend, who's super cool, by the way. By the way, hey, it's my friend first.
I don't care about Colin. You can be his friend.
You care. Don't act like you don't care.
So, you thought you'd get your friends to beat me up, huh?
Leave me alone, you're just a bully.
Well, you and your friends are about to see how much of a bully I really am.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check on those guys.
You do that.
Okay, I'm trying to tell you guys, this kid's evil.
Yeah, you know what, Ethan? We're evil too. I'm stealing candy right now.
Right, and you used to inspire us. Look at you now.
Look. I asked you guys to help me just take care of
it. You asked us to fix this for you.
Yeah, and as soon as you guys are friends, problem solved.
Guys, hurry up with the chips and pop. Chop, chop.
Push on your side.
Almost. I don't know what. The door's not.
So there was only one pop in there for some reason.
Well, it's not yours anyway.
I don't get it.
Yeah.
You two look like Dumb and Dumber fans. Or Beefs and Butthead. I'll let you decide.
Stop sucking up to them.
Ethan, he said we could choose.
A night at the Roxbury.
I'll let you decide on one condition. You hit him.
I don't know about that.
Whoa!
Ow!
Dude!
That's a classic. I haven't seen it in a long time.
How did it feel?
It's kind of like kissing another dude. Hypothetically.
Think of a celebrity.
Satisfying, but conflicting.
Bullies aren't just in the schoolyard. They have a new playground on social media. Posting inappropriate photos and spreading rumors are just another way of shoving and punching.
You never notice how, like, everyone's teenagers a little shit, and they don't listen, and they don't trust their parents, and they think they're full of shit?
That sounds like me.
Exactly. But at some point, like, your parents told you that Santa Claus was real, and then they woke, then one day they're like, yeah, we actually lied about that. Like, who's f***ing who over, really?
Right. I knew it was a work when Santa Claus smelled like Uncle Carl one year.
And Uncle Carl smells like...
brute.
Right.
Don't change who you are. Please be proud of who you are.
Don't be a bully.
I knew. I was drinking in Belgium.
So, you live in a public restroom. You have no money. And the only thing you have is family. Family. So you have family.
I mean, I try to beat up my brother.
My sister ignores me. But she's kind of a bitch.
So, let's change that.
Do you know how to beat Johnny Turbo?
Don't trust him.
Ethan, this is my friend.
Justin's right. Is that any way to speak to your friends?
Because it's not.
I want you to break into your family's house and steal any valuables that they have.
So are you just going to steal from yourself while we're gone?
No. I'll stay here and we'll split it three ways.
What about Ethan?
I'm not a part of this. I could not have said it better myself.
Are you f***ing kidding me? Even I'm not that evil.
So, we have a deal?
No. Okay, you two are the dumbest people on the f***ing planet, okay? You're getting manipulated by a 12-year-old.
14.
Okay, I don't give a shit what age you are, okay? F*** you. F*** both of you. If you had even half a brain between the both of you, you would cut him out, okay? You're getting manipulated into stealing from the only people that can even tolerate you by this asshole. I thought you were the manager, and I thought you were the talent, okay? You tell me.
Well, kid, you finally stood up to him. I knew you had it in you.
I like that you tied this together like we actually had a plan.
Two!
Sweet! Come on, guys. Let's listen to some Manny's music. I have Alanis Morissette in here somewhere.
It's a death row pardon.
2 minutes too late.
Wait, guys. You can't beat a bully by becoming a bully.
Wow.
You're right.
Friends.
Alright. Now go get us some pop, assholes.
I thought this was like an after-school special.
My phone was at 25 degrees outside.
Oh, yeah. Give me my coats back.
No, we already have those coats for lunch.
Sure. And, good luck with your money tree, too.
I told you there'd be a payoff for that.
And I'm going to tell you something right now. There's one guarantee in life, and that there are no guarantees. Yeah. Dig it.